SpaceX Starship Updates and Perseverance T-minus 2 weeks. My name is Felix, and I am your host for today's episode of What About It. And as always, there has been a lot going on in the space industry lately, so let's dive right in. Starship Updates. SpaceX is as always going all in on the Starship program in Boca Chica, and it shows everywhere.
Yeah, it does.
The construction site is growing to never seen heights, the launch site is preparing for serial number 5's first hop and for future super heavy launches, and the rest of the space industry has all eyes on South Texas. And what still keeps surprising everyone, including me, is the rate of progression. Remember how I said 2 weeks ago that the new high bay intended for super heavy construction is going up really fast? This is how far SpaceX is already. Maria Pointer did a huge video about what's going on in Boca Chica, her neighborhood, right now. Make sure to show her some love in the comments for what she does for the space community. Non-exclusive footage is harder and harder to get, and she still is one of the few providing her history recordings for everyone, not just for her own financial benefits. Thank you, Maria. So this is how far SpaceX is with the super heavy high bay right now. Utilizing a 120 meter tall crawler crane, the Boca Chica crew is building this very large facility out of pure necessity. First of all, Boca Chica is known to sometimes have hurricanes, and if one of them arrives, SpaceX needs to be prepared. Secondly, proper construction needs protection from the harsh South Texas environment. Construction methods in Boca Chica are getting more and more sophisticated, and so constructing a Starship or a Super Heavy out in the open as SpaceX tried last year is out of the question. So they need a huge building to accommodate a prototype as large as Super Heavy serial number 1. Many wall elements had been brought to the construction site in advance, and so the process is rapid. Two corners are already done, leaving a large gap in the middle. We can also see the same horizontal exterior structure as on the midbay. In case you were wondering why SpaceX is putting towel racks on the high bay's outer walls, those are structural support elements. Especially if a hurricane does come to Boca Chica, high winds could twist the walls and make them shake. The exterior support structure stiffens the walls and prevents this. To maximize internal space, SpaceX just puts the support structures on the outside, where on a normal storage building or anything similar, these would just go on the inside. In close-ups, it's incredible to see how much precision is needed from the crane operator to place these huge wall elements down. Well done, SpaceX workers. More and more semi-trucks are arriving at the site every day to feed the fast progress with needed construction material. It's a bit like an ant path leading down to Boca Chica. As already seen on the last episode, workers are equally busy at the launch site, getting the facilities ready for the next step in the Starship program, orbital flight. I know no Starship has ever lifted up just 1 meter from the ground, but that won't take long anymore, and SpaceX will not spend much time doing 150 meter hops. They will immediately want to continue, and for that, the right infrastructure needs to be in place. So terrain grading between the super heavy launch site and the older Starship test stand at the fuel farm continues every day. Huge amounts of gravel are being transported to the site to give the sandy Boca Chica ground some much needed support for larger constructions. A new test stand has now been worked on for a while as well, presumably for Starship serial number 6 if 5 destroys the stand, which unfortunately wouldn't be the first time. SpaceX is preparing for every eventuality to have as little delays as possible. Fingers crossed it won't be needed anytime soon. At the time of recording the episode, there was no static fire yet, but that might very well have happened by now. Next up after that would be the 150 meter hop. The new launch control center is making good progress as well. In the foreground, you can see Zeus's little red doghouse. It's the home of the Boston Dynamics Spot robot, which SpaceX is using for hazard assessment after Starship tests. With its thick concrete walls, the Launch Control Center almost looks like NASA's blockhouses they used for Redstone and Gemini launches back in the days. Extremely sturdy, small buildings that could withstand a rocket failure at close proximity. Very small windows and rebar reinforced concrete walls. On a side note, the recent test stage shift was likely caused by some sort of problem with the tank farm. The methane flare stack vented and tanker semi-trucks ordered to replenish the fuel farm for further testing were not allowed to enter the site and were instead forced to drive all the way back to the construction site in reverse. Funny picture, but definitely not so nice for the drivers. Carlos from iCANimation has been out at the site again as well, taking a beautiful picture of the new mass simulator mounted on Starship Serial Number 5. Everything is ready for the hop again, and even the viewing locations are growing as well. An observation deck has recently been built near the launch site, giving a beautiful viewing angle towards the SpaceX facility. There will be plenty more of these in the future if SpaceX continues at this pace. With Serial Number 5 waiting for its hop and everything around it under construction, the launch site once more shows how eager SpaceX is to get its number one priority going. They want to see a Starship orbital as much as we do. Do you want to know more? Then support me and my team with a like, a share, and most importantly with a subscription. There's a huge library of content on my channel covering all sorts of topics, and your subscription tells YouTube that you like what you saw. Thank you. It still is a guessing game when exactly we will finally see that first Starship hop, and it's probably the number one question you keep asking me, and it's one that I can at best guess on. It's safe to say though that SpaceX is working all hands on deck to turn this goal into reality as soon as humanly possible. Perseverance, T-minus 2 weeks. 2 weeks until NASA goes to Mars again. Only a few days are left until they try to repeat one of the most difficult tasks in robotic exploration once more. Perseverance is getting ready for the grand journey, and I'll give you the last few bits of information before liftoff.
We are a species of explorers.
Believers, we persevere. Under this motto, NASA right now is going into the final phase before the Mars 2020 launch window opens up on July 30th. We've always been driven to explore our solar system, but the attention we've given Mars in the past is on a whole other level. 57 missions have been sent to Mars so far, 29 of which were either complete or partial failures. That's more than half, more than every second mission. Especially NASA got better with it in recent years though. They have not had a failure since 1999 and the Mars Polar Lander. And especially in the last two decades, one class of mission towards the red planet gained popularity more and more. Rovers. Spirit, Opportunity, Curiosity, three extremely successful missions that widened our horizon and gave us countless insights into our closest neighbor. Now, Perseverance is ready to continue this legacy of rovers exploring the Martian surface. Perseverance is the biggest yet, weighing in at more than a metric ton and including a first in solar system exploration, a flying mini helicopter. Mars 2020 will set new records if it succeeds. Built to find life on Mars by drilling, collecting soil samples, and caching them for a later retrieval mission, Perseverance will accomplish tasks no other rover has tried to do yet. That's true. With 23 cameras on board, we are along for the ride more than ever before as well. 7 cameras have been specifically installed to film entry, descent, and landing for the world to see about 30 minutes after its landing on February 18th of 2021. A recently released video shows the deployment mechanism for Ingenuity, the helicopter carried by Perseverance to deploy shortly after landing. If this works, we will get aerial footage from the drone helicopter. Again, something never done before. Just recently, Mars 2020 with all the hardware got encapsulated in the ULA Atlas V fairing in preparation for the launch. As you can see, most parts of the fairing are covered with blue acoustic shock absorber plates to give the mission the smoothest possible ride. Everything is ready now, and we are counting the days to the launch. The Mars 2020 mission, together with the fairing, has already been transported to the Atlas V rocket as well and mounted on top. Everything is going as planned. Fingers crossed that Perseverance takes off without any problems and that it sends us the first ever full video coverage of a successful landing on Mars in early 2021. As a side note, NASA recently released a very nice 3D visualization that you can look at for free online to get a great overview of all the different systems that can be found on Perseverance. Every single part is animated, and if you click on the parts that interest you in particular, you get a new page full of details, spec sheets, and everything you'd possibly need to get your excitement up. NASA is putting a lot of effort into the safe trip for Mars 2020, and their track record has been great in the past two decades. The whole mission would be in vain if the rover does not arrive, so these last steps right before the launch are incredibly important. And this is something we don't only find in the space industry. Security and safety are an important factor of everything we do. This especially is true for the internet. Whether it's data and identity theft, traceability, intrusive advertising, or geo-blocking. Surfshark VPN encrypts your data and turns you into a harder target for attackers to get, and if you're a tough target, they'll go somewhere else. All streaming services have different catalogs in different countries. What if you could watch them all? Just activate your VPN, change your virtual location, refresh the page, and your libraries are basically doubled. I use Surfshark every day. It automatically starts up whenever I start my PC, and whenever I need it, I activate it with just one click. Surfshark offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, so there is no risk. Use my code to get 85% off plus 3 extra months for free, and at the same time support What About It. Surf with your own rules, links in the description. Welcome to the Patron and YouTube member shoutout, where I take the time to honor those who go above and beyond to support the channel with ideas, funding and help. Today's shoutout goes to Christopher Castoro, Christian Bergman, Martin Bioli, Skuck's Steam Channel and many others. You rock! And I also, as always, want to give a massive shout out to my team. Without you people, this all would not be possible. Thank you very much. You rock. So this wraps up today's episode of What About It? Is SpaceX building a blockhouse in the tradition of the old Redstone launch sites? And will NASA extend its record of sending rovers to Mars successfully? As always, tell me in the comments. 2020 launch window opens up on July. Spirit, opportunity, curiosity.